Welcome to The Icon. Today we have this amazing personality who's been striving for the last 20 years to promote Ayurveda, to bring in awareness about Ayurveda, the ancient science of healing from India in Western Australia. Ladies and gentlemen, let me have the honor to introduce Neeraja Ahuja on The Icon.
Welcome,
Neeraja ji.
Thank you for inviting me.
Well, so tell us about your journey. You have been into Ayurveda for the last 20 years. And
yes.
You started off with just something to bring in an awareness within the community, which actually took wings and, you know, it brought you this establishment that you have today. Tell us about this journey.
Well, it has been a very interesting journey for me. I didn't start with Ayurveda. I am originally a database programmer, so my background is computing and statistics. So this was not even in my dreams to do something like that. But I say it is destiny. I just had taken time off work so that I can spend time with my two children after my second one was born, and so would be that I came across my teacher, who is an MBBS doctor as well as MD and an Ayurveda practitioner, and I was doing another course from a place called Landmark Education, where I had to do something that inspires me. So my idea was just to run a seminar on Ayurveda conducted by other people, because it inspired me. I grew up in India, I knew about Ayurveda, I had used Ayurveda, but this was still not my idea of something that I would do it. But I think that seminar got me hooked. We had about 350 people attend that particular seminar.
Right. So that's a very interesting way, you know, how you found your calling in Ayurveda. Now tell us, what is the most inspiring thing about Ayurveda? Like, why did you think that, you know, this was, you know, the kind of system that you want to follow? The reason I ask you this is because your center is called the Ayurvedic Awareness Center, and it doesn't talk about the clinical aspects or the medical aspects of Ayurveda, which I find is extremely beautiful, because we all understand, coming from India or having an Indian background, we understand that Ayurveda is not just, you know, a medicinal system, but more of a lifestyle. So could you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, as I said, that it wasn't my planned profession. It was something that I thought I was just going to do one seminar and that's it, and go back to being the programmer that I used to be. And that never happened. And my husband also, who's an engineer, and both of us were inspired, and I was at home with children at that time, so I had a bit of time, not too much. Children did keep me busy, and I started getting calls from people, and people wanted something more, because it was a very inspiring experience to attend that particular seminar, and people did ask me, well, are you going to continue? And I'm saying, no, I, you know, that was not my idea at that time. But anyway, we did some more seminars, and then there was an opportunity to attend a one-year program. So we organized that in Perth. And what inspired me was my teacher, who is a medical professional as well. And the way he was teaching and he introduced, it was like Ayurveda has different aspects: mind, body, senses, and the soul. These are the four aspects of looking at life. And soul being as part of medical system was not something that people think about when they think of going to a doctor. They don't go for the soul things. And but it was interesting to see that what is possible, and actually that was the most fascinating aspect for me. And you know, it wasn't the money bit. I can tell you that programmers earn way more than Ayurvedic practitioner was earning, and so that wasn't something that moved me. But it was just, we made a decision ultimately, and I'm grateful to my husband for that as well, that we made a transition knowing that I may not be earning so much, but it gave me a lot more flexibility to be around my children, which I wanted to do, and continue with something that had interested me. And as I said, it was my calling. And when we started, nobody kind of knew even the name Ayurveda. I had to spell it out, I had to tell the meaning.
You've come a long way from there. In fact, yes. The one thing that caught my attention was when you mentioned about connection between mind, body and soul. For the sake of our viewers, you know, I'm sure most of us, you know, most of their viewers out there would love to know what's this connection, you know, how is this soul connected, and what according to you is this soul?
Okay, well, this is a bit hard to answer. What is soul is very subjective. Nobody, it is so subtle. It is subtler than my mind. So it's very hard to quantify. I can just give my expression or what I am, my understanding. So, or let us look at from practical perspective, from, you know, in Ayurveda, we are talking about healing and health, and how that concept is used is, for example, you get stressed, okay? Life, everybody gets stressed.
Oh yes, we all do get stressed.
Right? And why, if we start thinking about why, what is going on from the perspective of health and well-being, so that we can provide some healing. See, challenges are always going to come to your life. If, say, you consider yourself that big and the situation in front of you is that, it's easy, right? But if I am thinking of, this is who I am, and my challenge is, or work in front of me is that big, then it can be, depending on who we are, depending on what we call as body type, we may take it as challenge and fun and joy, or it could be a bit stressful. But if this is who I am and this is how my job in front of me is, it is going to be beyond me, right? And the moment I think this is me and this is the work in front of me, whatever the level is, but every individual sooner or later will encounter something like that, and that will cause us stress, right? But if I am connected with what I call a soul, which is something which is beyond me, which is beyond my body, then the more I'm connected to that, you know, the Sanskrit word or the Hindi word for that is the Atma, and we also give the analogy of Atma and Paramatma. So it is the analogy of the wave and the ocean. So if
you can say
I am
being and supreme being.
Yeah, so it is the wave, my existence, the more I am connected with my existence is like the wave in that ocean. So we are all one, it is the ocean. And just as the wave rises and has its own existence for some time, and then it merges back into the ocean. So if that's how we are, then the more I'm connected with that ocean, I don't have to worry about my existence as a wave all the time. Because then I can see, the more I'm connected with that supreme, the soul, or whatever we want to call it, Atma, soul, divinity, higher self, whatever name we want to call it, the more I'm connected with that, I know everything is accessible, everything is part of the plan. Then I don't have to do I don't have to get stressed about things, because then there is always a way out, which I may not be aware of right now yet, but it is possible. So it kind of de-stresses people, you know, and it is a medically proven and useful thing. It is known by science now as well that people, for example, who pray, they certain things they just find it easier to work with. Like there are certain stresses that can be reduced because you are letting go of that responsibility. You're taking action about the responsibility, but also at the same time somehow you are letting go and know that there are higher powers.
Very interesting. So are you saying that Ayurveda is not something that, you know, would fascinate atheists?
No, it is. We are talking from medical science perspective. I'm not really.
When you say when people pray, I understand that, you know, atheists don't believe in a concept of God or supreme being, and they don't really have something like that. Where, how do we feature Ayurveda for such people?
You don't have to be a believer. Because
that's where I want to take you to. Yes.
Yes. So because it's a medical science, it's a health science.
So can I say, if I have to pray, I can pray to nature, or, you know, feel yes, grateful, and that is that more than enough?
Yes, that is enough, and that is also not the only thing that we are working with. The beauty of Ayurveda is that you can work with when patients come to me, you can work with mind, body, senses, and the soul. These are the four aspects. So we can totally work with the body. There are herbs that can be used to treat whatever is required.
The physical body, yes.
Physical body. So wherever the person is, whatever level that they are at, Ayurveda is able to meet that. Because if you are not at all interested in that aspect, the soul aspect, you don't worry about it. You know, people come they want some physical things to be fixed, and definitely you can work with that. And that is what I find very fascinating, that you can meet people at any level that they are ready as a practitioner. Or that is the, you know, it's not just me, it is Ayurveda that is there, that you can meet people wherever they are. You can work at the physical level, you can work on mental health level. And if somebody wants to go beyond, we can look at that as well. But that is their own personal thing. It is their own personal experience. Doesn't need to be affecting their medical health, the minimum things that they want to look at.
Lovely. So you're one of those first institutions who was recognized by the government of Australia for imparting Ayurvedic education to the locals. So what exactly do you do, and, you know, what level of education do you provide, and up to what level of education in Ayurveda is possible in Australia?
Okay, so, you know, when I was actually studying, we had done few seminars and decided to do a 1 year course. And that's what we were doing. We were about 18 of us in that group, in our first batch. And while we were studying, Ayurveda got recognized as a health modality in Australia. So we were in that flow, and so we decided to become a registered training organization. And so that's what we did. We started running Cert 4 in Ayurveda as well as advanced diploma in Ayurveda. So these are the two things that we were doing, and we did it for many, many years. And it's only last about 3 years or so, I have decided, I've worked out that I want to work with people who are ready to use it. Though we have had few medical professionals, few GPs have studied with us, and there has been a gynecologist and a cardiologist who has also studied with us. And I realized that most of the people who are coming, they are more interested in using it and its application rather than just having a paper.
Absolutely. And what I see is that, you know, when other medical practitioners actually learn Ayurveda, they use it as an integrated approach. And it's not just a one-sided Ayurvedic or, you know, a traditional medicinal approach, but, you know, instead an integrated approach which provides an all-round holistic healing experience.
That is absolutely right. I have had, like as I was saying, there have been few GPs who have done this course with us. Mm-hmm. So we run a one-year course called Foundation Training in Clinical Ayurveda and Self-Care. Mm-hmm. And so, and she was telling me that this is one of the best things that she has done, because it adds depth to what she was already doing as a medical professional, because now she has learned to look at that by the time person comes and sits in front of her, she knows about the body type or the prakriti, as we call it in language of Ayurveda. She knows the prakriti. She knows, as the patient starts talking about what is going on, she also knows about the imbalance from Ayurvedic perspective. And so she can add a little bit of diet and lifestyle things for them, and it adds value. So she can see the benefits of how people are getting better by what she's able to give, other than the things that she can do as a medical professional. So it is very, very good to know. For us, it is about lighting more candles, that people are learning to use it for themselves, their family, their friends. And in the case of other practitioners, they are also able to extend that to their clients as well.
Beautiful. In fact, another fascinating thing that I found about your practice, Neerja, is that, you know, you also impart cooking workshops, Ayurvedic style of cooking. So could you elaborate on a little bit on that?
Look, it's a new concept that we give when we
start. Or is it actually a very ancient concept back in India?
Back in India, it is ancient concept, but again, even everywhere we have to learn. So fortunately, like people like us who grew up in India, we had some background.
Exposure,
but
yes.
When people are learning this as a totally new concept, one of the things that starts to happen is, what do I eat now? You know, that is something, suddenly they find that the foods that they have been eating, they're not necessarily the best foods for them. So that was what brought that we started doing some cooking demos as well, time to time, so that people can come and have a look and taste and see the foods, because some of that they have never cooked. And we teach them something, some as simple as how to make khichdi, which is simple dal, mung dal and rice, and we kind of modify for healthy people. We'll add some vegetables, so it is a one pot meal, and it is so yummy and nice, but it is always good. But also we talk to people about what is there in their repertoire already, and so how they can modify their own food, so that they don't have to totally learn different thing altogether all the time. But we, when we are doing individually, then we also look at what are they already doing and what modifications can be done. And because diet and lifestyle, these are two very important part or aspects of preventative health, and if we are doing those well, then medication may or may not even be required. That's what Ayurveda says, that if we are doing these two well, we are looking after ourselves, we may not need the medication.
Beautiful. Like how I came across the term swasthya, you know, to be healthy, and, you know, a state of well-being yes. for the self, you know, to root oneself, that makes absolute sense. In fact, yes. It was great having a chat with you, Dr. Neerj Ahuja. The best thing about, what I felt about your practice was that, you have, strived and, made sure that, you impart education about Ayurveda to the Australian community. You were also ensured that, they start coming into a healthy lifestyle, which Indians are used to back home, but how can the world benefit from such a therapy or from such a practice? So totally love your holistic approach, and we wish you all the very best. Thank you so much for joining us on The Icon. You are truly a captivating personality and your work is amazing. Thank you once again.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me here.